It's been about 1 week since I switched to Linux, and I made the Linux leap of faith. No dual booting, none of that. I straight up ripped out my Windows SSD and put in a fresh SSD with just Linux on it. And here it is. Whoa, that was some dramatic lighting change. Basically, to talk about the advantages and the disadvantages, I want to play a little game called Red Light, Green Light. Red light, green light. Let's go. A big green light is the customization, and I've only just barely scratched the surface with this. Linux in general gives you so much control over the operating system, it's actually insane. And it does take a bit of time and effort to get into those config files and make things the way you want. And there's a whole community of people that do this much better than me. Linux Ricing is a huge thing. I'm really inspired by what I see on those subreddits, but pretty much I feel good knowing that there's so much I can do to change the operating system and how it looks to pretty much whatever I want. So that's a big green light. I haven't really exercised a lot of this power yet. All I've done so far is attach some programs to some hotkeys so that I can open them up like, you know, with a click of a button, which is something that's pretty common in other operating systems as well. So customization is a big green light, but a red light I encountered was a Wi-Fi driver issue. Basically, when I opened up my laptop from sleep, the Wi-Fi just wouldn't work. And I had to power the whole thing down, wait for a bit, open it up again in order to make the Wi-Fi work again. And this is after spending a couple of hours troubleshooting and searching the internet for what seemed like a long time. The reason why this is so bad is because I had a final exam, and it was an open book final exam where I was allowed access to my notes on my laptop. If this issue had happened during then, I would have just completely been destroyed. Like, there's no way I could have finished the exam fully without having access to all the notes. So that's definitely a big instability that I think is a red light for this Linux experience so far. But on the topic of instability, I haven't noticed any instability with any hardware. So that's definitely a green light. I was going into this expecting some kind of driver issues to pop up other than the Wi-Fi stuff, but I haven't noticed that. It works really well with my NVIDIA graphics card and my laptop, and nothing else other than the Wi-Fi really ends up being an issue as far as hardware integration with my laptop. So that's definitely a green light. Speaking of integrations though, a big problem I have right now is DaVinci Resolve. I thought DaVinci Resolve was going to be working on Linux, so I'm a bit surprised that even though I installed everything and it's all, the app shows up in the program launcher, it just won't start. Granted, I did try this, you know, 2 days ago, so maybe I just need to do a bit more finicking with it, but that's something I expect to kind of work out the box, especially because DaVinci Resolve has a Linux version of their program. So the fact that it doesn't work out the box is kind of frustrating. Speaking of programs though, I do have to say that installing apps is actually a pretty fun experience, apps that work, obviously. So instead of having to download and run through an installer, you just type in through your package manager, sudo pacman-s, and then the name of the app, and it just downloads itself pretty much. And honestly, I like that kind of app install experience. Just type out what you want and it'll install everything for you. No need to do all this clicking and installing steps and all that stuff. I like that about Linux, just the app install environment. So that's red light and green light, but reality often isn't as black and white. So I have a couple of yellow lights as well I want to talk about. The first thing is engineering app compatibility. So I'm in engineering, doing my master's right now, and one of the main things I've been wary of is the fact that SolidWorks is hard to get running on Linux. And it's one of those things where my line of work or study requires some apps and programs that I wish would work seamlessly on the operating system on Linux, but it's not as simple as it sounds. So that's something I'm pretty wary about right now. Another thing is Google Drive compatibility. I found a way around this because what I wanted Google Drive for was syncing my Obsidian Vault, and Obsidian is a note-taking app I use. The workaround I found was I just used a sync thing instead, so it's peer-to-peer syncing instead of cloud syncing. So that's another workaround I had, and I wish I didn't have to use that, so it's a bit of a yellow light. Again, it's only been around a week, so take everything I say with a grain of salt. But the things I do want to talk about, and I think are applicable to everybody, are the concepts of loser's games and winner's games and aspirational purchasing. So this whole experiment started with me being a bit naive about Linux. I thought if I started using Linux, I'd become a computer wizard. I'd be forced to learn everything I need to learn about computers, and I'd just become more connected with the cyber world, whatever nonsense I was thinking back then. That's not exactly the case. That was a form of aspirational purchasing, or in this case, it's an aspirational OS switching, whatever you want to call it. What I found from that is that it's easier to think that you're going to do something because you force yourself to use a certain tool or a program, but that's not always going to be the case. No doubt using Linux has taught me some new things about operating systems, which I would never have considered before, but it wasn't as big of a deal as I thought it would be. And I think this point is important because it applies to everybody and every choice they make. I know a lot of you people out there are looking for a new laptop, and aspirational purchasing is definitely going to be a factor you have to look out for. Because a lot of times when you're looking for a new tool, new laptop, you'll be trying to buy something that fits a lifestyle they think you want to live. So be careful of that. I'd suggest look at your actual needs and your use cases right now and purchase off that. Don't fall into the trap of becoming an aspirational purchaser, because that just ends up giving you buyer's regret more often than not. The second thing I want to talk about is personal computing a winner's game or a loser's game? So to quickly define, a winner's game is pretty much a game where you win by actually making active plays and gaining points, whereas a loser's game is won by avoiding losing points. And so the best example I have is volleyball. It's both a winner's game and a loser's game, because at a high level, it's a winner's game. You have to play well and you have to earn points. You have to make those hits and spikes. Whereas at a lower amateur level, it's a loser's game, because more often than not, by just playing good fundamental volleyball, you'll avoid mistakes and the opposing team is going to make more mistakes than you. So it's a difference between either winning by making points or winning by avoiding losing points. And so here's where I think it ties in with computing. I think personal computing, for the most part, is a loser's game. You want to avoid making mistakes rather than eking out the best top 1% performance. On the flip side, creating a computer, that is definitely a winner's game. You win the market by making good products, or at least that's what it should be. We can argue about that later. So the reason this is important is because when it comes to me and my choice of operating system or choice of laptop, for a while, I think I've been approaching it as a winner's game where I'm trying to find out the best performing laptop and what's going to do the most things for me. Whereas instead, I should be thinking about it more in terms of a loser's game, where what laptop is going to be good at avoiding mistakes. The Wi-Fi driver issue with Linux is probably the best example I have of not playing the loser's game properly. Even though I have this amazing customizable operating system, I'm losing points by not having stable access to Wi-Fi, which is arguably one of the most important things a laptop needs in the first place. It's only been a week. We'll see how it goes. I don't think I'm gonna be switching, you know, tonight, obviously, but I am less confident about my ability to stick with this. In my first video, I said I'd give it about a 75-25% chance. 75% chance I stay with Linux. Now it's more of a 50-50. Depending on my engineering software compatibility and just, you know, how stable the system is, I think I'm on the fence as to whether to stick with this or to go back to Windows 10, which has its own host of problems since it's ending its life support in October of 2025. So I'm at a bit of a crossroads right now. And honestly, I don't know what to do, but I'll keep you updated. Also, before I end the video off, I do want to make a very important point. I use Arch, by the way.